It has been, baby. Yeah, a deep sea is what I need right now. But anyways, hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I think this is going to be a different channel from what I initially wanted it to be for. This is, I think you can see by the title of this video that it's going to be different, very much different. And welcome to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time here, thank you very, very, very much for clicking the play button. And if you've been here from day one and you're just like, I don't even know why I'm subscribing to no content, thank you. Everything has a season, everything has a reason, and that's what I've come to know and to realize for sure, not just saying it, but it being the thing that happens, you know. And never mind, if I'm so daddy in the background, I am now a mother. I am a mother. I also have flu. Yes, baby, I also have flu. This is my diary sessions, season one, episode one. When I thought picking up the camera will be for a good reason, which it still is for a good reason even now, but when I thought it would be for me to share my journey of being pregnant after trying for so many months, and only for my husband to say, deuces. You can do this by yourself, girl. You know, we laugh about pain, but not intentionally so, just to cope, you know. Wait, you promised me, Azania, Azania, guys, my baby is teething, okay? My baby is teething, so it's just been going through the most, and she's the one who actually gave me this flu. I was like, why, girl? And I don't know why I'm sucking your mask. Well, I don't know why I'm sucking your mask, because not getting your mask when I'm around you. So yeah, guys, I just wanna diarize my thoughts, you know, so that when my daughter grows up and certain questions she asked me, I'll be able to just direct her to the video. Or if I feel like I don't have the strength to answer her, she will just come to those videos and watch them and maybe understand. And I pray that she takes my attitude, the attitude I have on life. I pray that she adopts most of the things I do. But besides, that's why I walk properly, because I don't want her. I don't want her. Baby, oh my God, why in the video? You want to be the video? Yeah, okay, guys, like I was saying, I want her to not just only learn from what I tell her, I want her to learn from how I walk, you know. Learn from how I talk, you know. She's looking at me, obviously. She's looking. I cannot say to her, don't drink Coke, but I'm drinking Coke. And by the way, guys, yo. By the way, I drink Coke. I drink Coke. I think that's my other coping mechanism, because I cannot be found out here drinking alcohol for what? To impress who? I was never a fan of it. Why should I be a fan of it now? And I'm absolutely not judging anybody who's drinking to like get rid of the pain. Grieving is hard. Grieving is heavy. A heart of a widow is heavy. And I'm sharing my story on this platform because I know a few other people who are going through what I'm going through, people who have went through what I'm going through, people who are still yet to go through what we're going through, even if it's not losing a husband, but losing a child. I've been there as well. I had so many miscarriages before having lasagna. So I know that as well. You know, grief is hard, guys. Grief is hard. It's just on you which mask you're going to put. Well, sometimes I have. Yeah. Let me find a tissue. I'll be back. As I was saying, guys, I don't want to be all over. This is just my little introduction to the episodes that will come after this one. Just let me just give you a backstory on who I am. My name is Betty. I am the only daughter and the last born. Children of three, including myself. I have two brothers, and then it's only more. Okay. I'm a daughter, I'm a friend. Most importantly, now I am a mother. You know, I am a widow, I am a young widow. I would have said I am a wife, but unfortunately, things happen, and so I'm a young widow. And I mean, I don't want to cry, but I think these are things that are going to happen in this episode. I'm going to be vulnerable because these are my diary sessions. This is just me venting, because sometimes you don't want to bother people. You know, as much as you'd be going through things, not everyone will understand what you're going through. And I have amazing support, guys. I am surrounded by so much love. I have a great support system, you know. But at the same time, I don't think they understand what I deal with on a day-to-day. But especially a person who didn't get the chance to bury their husbands. I didn't get to bury my husband. Those are things I'm going to share with you guys on why, you know, my own reasonings. And I don't want anybody to think somehow of my in-laws, like they did what was best for them. I only see the positive even in the negative. So I'm just like, everybody has their own story. I also have my story. Let me share mine and just heal the next person, you know. Maybe someone will learn something from my story, you know, and they will grab some hope, Yana, from everything that other people go through. I believe that we all go through things, but we don't go through them the same way, you know. So, but sharing is caring, guys. Sharing is caring, because I don't think nobody told me, nobody, for real. No one said to me, if your husband dies first, just know that you're the one who killed him. Nobody told me that. I'm only finding that now because everybody's sharing their stories with me. And they're like, you're not the first one, dear. You're absolutely even not the last one. That's what happens. A man is not supposed to die first, you know. If he dies, even if he was cheating on you, and he gets into an accident with the side chick, it's still your fault that they got into an accident, you know? I just want us to share, guys. I want us to share. Be open enough to also tell me your stories, you know? Let's heal together. Like, this is my way of healing. Let's heal together. Grief is heavy. I will say that over and over. Grief is so heavy. And I wake up other days and I'm in the middle of the night and I'm just angry. And I'm like, why? Like, I'm asking my husband this. I'm like, why? You know? I'm going to share with you guys, although there are certain other parts of the stories that I can't share in detail until I've made up my mind about what I want to do with those people who are accusing me of killing my own husband. Until then, I can't.
There are certain things I would not be able to share in detail, but I will later on, after I have done what I need to do, I will later on share with you guys on what happened, what my 1 plus 1 is equals to, the answer I got. This is my intro. Welcome to the widow's heavy heart. We're grieving together. We're gonna laugh. We're gonna cry. We're gonna blame. We're going to hate, and still, we are going to curse. Not verbally. We're gonna do it internally. And we're just gonna do a lot of things together. And I hope that we heal and we share our stories together in the name of healing. My daughter is so well, guys. She has flu. Sorry, mama. Sorry, my baby. Sorry, Standosa. Oh, the news. She's so adorable. She's so adorable. She is. She is. She's my life, that one. I mean, she gave me a sense of hope when I didn't see any.